Alright guys, welcome back to another video. Today we have a bunch of updates on this flashlight over here. So I have been working on making quite a few changes. First one, which is right over here, I put a fan filter on the inside of the intake fan. So that way it draws less dust and hair or whatever there is in the air that doesn't go to the LED. So keeps it clean on the inside. And I also added this a little thing over here for voltage monitoring the 1S LiPo battery. You always want to have something to show you the voltage because LiPo batteries should not drop below 2.8 volts per cell or they can be damaged. So this will let me see what the voltage is and know when to turn the flashlight off. Over here we have a temperature sensor. So this one, hooked up to the battery right now. It doesn't display correctly all the time because this is for 5 volts and the battery we have only does 3.7. But when it's fully charged, it does between 4 and 4.2 and that's enough to give us a good temperature reading over here. It doesn't heat up that much, so it's not too important. But yeah, currently the temperature sensor is on this side of the heatsink, not where the LED is. So it doesn't really show that much. I will move it sometime in the future when I get the chance. I'll move it closer to the LED to get a more accurate reading. Okay, so when we turn it on, bam. So we got the temperature over here. You can see it's saying 24.5. The 2 doesn't really show correctly because the voltage is low on the battery. And here we got this. It's blinking 3.9 volts, so charged and ready to go. This is at full power, and yeah, so when this is over 4, then the temperature monitor actually displays this final digit over here correctly, but it still works. So you can see this is actually 25.1 degrees, and it increases as the flashlight is on for longer periods of time. I haven't seen it go over 30 degrees at all, so that's very nice. But to get a more accurate reading, the temperature sensor should be closer to the LED, which I'll have to do soon. But yeah, red and red. There wasn't really one of these temperature monitors that actually displayed like this one with red lines on a black background. So I went with the closest thing, which was black lines on a red background. And I think it doesn't look too bad. So we got that blinking. It blinks because this is actually made for 1 to 6 cell batteries. And it's actually searching for more cells each time, but it only finds one cell and then it displays the voltage for that one cell. So it's pretty cool. That's what it looks like. I'll turn it off over here. And yeah, so now let's compare this flashlight to the flashlight I originally used. So if you saw the first episode, I think it was, pretty sure I posted some pictures of this flashlight, which was just a TK41 with the reflector removed and then put inside a tube with a lens. And this had a range of, I think it was almost 800 meters or something. I could actually see the spot on the top of a mountain. And I just tested these side by side outside. And this one is definitely brighter. Of course, it's not as concentrated as this one because this has a proper high quality lens on it, but it is does waste a lot more light. So this one has a brighter spot. It has a physically larger beam because the lens is larger and that makes the beam more visible and the spot is brighter. So haven't tested this at that long range yet, but it is definitely brighter than this one that I originally used. Now, a different comparison is that this one has actually been de-domed. You probably can't see that, but I de-domed it myself, and the color temperature is still very bright white. However, this one, which I bought already de-domed, has a more yellowish color, which is actually normal for for when you do dome on LED, that the temperature actually gets a bit warmer, it gets some kind of yellow or green. It doesn't happen with all types of LEDs, and it didn't seem to happen with this one, but I'll show you some pictures of this in just a moment, and you'll clearly see that it has a much yellower color, sort of like that of a regular incandescent light bulb. It's not really a problem for me as long as it's bright, but I do have an extra LED, and maybe I can always buy a different one in the future, change the LED, find something that has a cool temperature, just because I think white looks a bit better. But it is bright. I need to do some more tests, and that's pretty much finished for now, except for the lens, which we are going to talk about in just a moment. Okay, so due to the bad quality of the original lens that I bought from Fastech, it works, but it's not the best. I decided to try getting a high quality lens from a proper optics manufacturer. So this is a lens from Edmund Optics, and I bought it for about $50, so it's a lot more expensive, 5 times more expensive than that one, or even more. And it's actually a much better quality lens. It has more uniform lighting, and you can see that it doesn't have any artifacts in the projection. But the problem is that it doesn't actually concentrate the light properly. So yeah, it was a bit disappointing. I thought it was gonna work. It actually didn't. I'll post an image so you guys can actually see that it creates sort of like a concentrated dot. I was trying to get the same effect as this lens, where it's a very small spot, but it actually also creates sort of like a round, large circle around the hot spot, and all that light is being wasted. And I realized that light is actually coming from the outside of this lens. So if you look at the lens from about this big, then it actually does concentrate the light just like this one does, but all the light that's supposed to be coming from the outside, that just gets wasted, and basically this would create a spot just as bright as this one. So it didn't really work, because it also had to be farther away, less light is hitting the lens, and then only this much light could actually be used. So yeah, this is not going to work for our flashlight. I'm actually going to make a video on how to choose your lens in a week or so, so that you guys can actually get some information on how to find the right lens that will work. And I think the reason that this lens did not work is because it's not a spherical lens. It's actually a spherical lens. So due to the way that it has a curvature, it refracts light rays in a different manner than an aspherical lens does, and that basically does not make a perfect spot like I was hoping. But I do have more lenses on order from Fastech, so we're going to try some other lenses out, and hopefully we'll find something that works better than this, and better than the one I was using before, which is this one. So yeah, that's pretty much it for this episode. I've made just a bunch of progress on the electronics here. There's a lot more wiring inside, kind of messy, but I can't really do anything about that. But yeah, video on how to choose the right lens is going to be coming up, and hopefully the new lenses I get from Fastech are going to increase the brightness even more. So looking forward to that, and after I think in a couple of weeks I'll actually be going outside with a much better camera and one of my friends, and we're going to do a bunch of videos and beam shots of this flashlight in much higher quality. So looking forward to that, and I'll see you guys in the next one.